From teenage crushes to fighting his ex-fiancée to save the world and eventually finding love. This is the complete timeline of Bolin's relationships in The Legend of Korra. Unlike his brother Mako, the young pro-bender wasn't so much concerned with winning games as he was with adoring fans. The two brothers, however, realized they completely misjudged the Avatar, and she soon brought her talents to their team, the Fire Ferrets.
You're the Avatar, and I'm an idiot.
Both are true.
No way.
The Avatar!
After Korra saved Bolin from the Equalists, he was completely smitten and decided to pay her a visit.
Wow, thanks. What's this for?
I can't remember now. Oh yeah, now I remember. You saved me from Amon.
Oh, that? It was no big deal.
Oblivious to the signs that Korra had a crush on his brother, Bolin later tried to ask her out more directly.
I gotta head back to the Air Temple to train with Tenzin. See ya.
Frustrated, the young earthbender went to his brother for advice, but an awkward love triangle was taking shape.
What do you think of Korra in a girlfriend sort of way?
She's great, but I think it makes more sense for me to go for Asami.
I was talking about a girlfriend for me. Leave some ladies for the rest of us.
Not knowing that Korra had just been rejected, Bolin stepped in and showed how charming he can be.
You're the smartest, funniest, toughest, buffest, talentedest, incrediblest girl in the world!
Flattered and clearly grateful for the confidence boost, Korra accepted Bolin's offer for a date. It wasn't long, though, before Bolin stumbled into his brother not following his own advice. Sorry, Bolin. Breaking hearts is kind of Mako's thing.
Bolin, this isn't what you think.
The pro-bending match that followed was rough for the divided Fire Ferrets. Only through sheer force of will was Korra able to clinch a solo victory. Back in the locker room, the overjoyed teammates put aside their drama and agreed to remain friends.
We had fun together, didn't we?
I had a great time, honestly. You are one of a kind, Bolin.
After defeating the Equalists, Mako and Korra became a couple. And by Team Avatar's next adventure, Bolin was single and ready to mingle. It didn't take long before he set his sights on the daughter of the Northern Water Tribe chief, Eska. Or more accurately, she set her sights on him.
You amuse me. I will make you mine.
While Bolin initially attempted to impress his new girlfriend, it became clear he was also stuck with her twin brother, who never left Eska's side. Needless to say, the dynamic was weird. It didn't help that Eska was extremely controlling.
Why are you initiating physical contact with another woman?
Soon, Bolin went to the person he knew with the most experience at breaking hearts.
Ending a relationship is kind of like pulling off a blood-sucking leech. You just gotta rip it off and get it over with.
As might be expected, Bolin failed the first attempts. When he put his foot down, Eska insisted they do the exact opposite.
It is as if a great chasm has formed between us and nothing can bridge it.
Oh yes, I am so glad you understand.
Nothing that is, except marriage.
Groomed and dressed in his betrothal outfit, Bolin made a daring escape with Team Avatar. Fortunately, Varric's extremely fast boat saved everyone from Eska's wrath. Back in Republic City, Bolin then teamed up with Varric as an actor in his propaganda films. The young earthbender's charisma made him an instant star, but the success didn't help win over his co-lead Ginger. Out of all of Bolin's dating mishaps, this one might be the cringiest.
You're confusing Ginger the actress with Ginger the character.
It wasn't until Bolin found himself foiling a kidnapping plot that Ginger's feelings changed.
No! Bolin, look out!
After single-handedly ending the fight, Bolin clearly didn't mind his co-star's sudden affection.
You really are as dumb as those rocks. Of course we're a couple.
While the relationship was brief, at the very least, that kiss seemed to have a lasting impact on both of these mover stars. As the threat of Unalaq loomed, Bolin ended things with Ginger and returned to the South Pole. When reuniting with her ex-fiancé, Eska seemed to truly enjoy beating up Bolin.
Hello, my feeble turtle duck.
With little chance of fighting back this family of master waterbenders, it turned out the key to Bolin saving himself was to just be honest.
Eska, I've always loved you, and I've always wanted to be with you, but now that the world is ending, I'm never gonna get that chance!
The reconciled couple fought back against Unalaq's forces, and Team Avatar saved the world yet again. At last, Eska had let her icy exterior melt. But ultimately, a long-distance relationship wasn't going to work.
I will remember you fondly, my turtle duck.
A more emotionally mature Bolin was now there to support Mako when he needed him. Once the harmonic convergence brought new airbenders to the world, Bolin joined Team Avatar to help rebuild the air nomad culture. Forgetting he's handsome, famous, and charming, Bolin didn't even clock the newest airbending recruit who had an instant crush on him.
Opal, that's a beautiful name.
Thanks.
I'm Bolin.
Opal, but you already knew that.
It was only after another round of Mako's questionable dating tips that Bolin started to weird Opal out.
Do me a favor and stop trying. Well, don't stop trying. Just stop trying so much. Just be yourself.
Each facing the difficulty of learning unfamiliar bending types, the new couple connected immediately.
Look at us, talking about our feelings, supporting each other.
It's nice.
In the midst of the Red Lotus conflict, Bolin and Opal lost each other on separate adventures. They both had to brave their share of danger, but eventually reunited safe and sound. Talk about couples goals. Bolin found someone who could love him, bad jokes and all.
See what I did there? I put a sock in it. Literally.
Classic Bolin.
3 years into his relationship with Opal, Bolin joined forces with Kuvira's Earth Empire. While he thought his work was helping people, Opal hated that her boyfriend was allied with her adopted sister, who she strongly distrusted.
I've heard how you help towns. By conquering them.
The older but still immature Earthbender's misplaced loyalty caused a rift between Opal and everyone who cared about him. If Kuvira's poor management skills weren't enough, the threat of getting shipped off to a labor camp finally snapped Bolin back to reality. Barely escaping with Varric, Bolin had a strained but hopeful return back to his loved ones.
I know there's nothing I could do or no big gesture that can make up for all my mistakes, but that doesn't mean I'm gonna stop trying to win you back. Because I love you.
Agreeing to help Opal save her captured family, Bolin formulated the plan of Team Beifong's prison break. Together, they rescued everyone, and despite his mistakes, Opal realized that her boyfriend was a total keeper.
I think Bolin has worked his way out of the polar bear doghouse.
Yes!
When Kuvira began her assault on Republic City, Bolin and Opal fought back with Team Avatar. Nothing could stop Kuvira's blind rage, and she nearly hit her sister with a blast from her spirit cannon.
Opal!
The fight was relentless, but after great sacrifice, the Great Uniter was defeated. Soon, Opal got to watch her boyfriend officiate the wedding of his most devoted friend.
Varric and Julie have proven that even the longest of long shots can have a chance at happiness together.
Exemplifying his own words, Bolin and Opal's relationship flourished in a new era of peace. The young Earthbender began a new job as a police officer, and his girlfriend embraced life as an air nomad. As might be expected, Bolin's work-obsessed brother didn't make time for double dates. So when Opal and Bolin discovered that Korra and Asami were officially a couple, they were ecstatic. Mako, on the other hand, had mixed feelings about his ex's dating. Now arguably more mature than his older brother, Bolin talked him through it, and Mako eventually came around. Even as new threats emerged, Bolin and Opal were now closer than they might have ever been. When a rogue faction of Earth Empire soldiers tried to take power, however, Bolin's relationship was put to its greatest test so far. While traveling to negotiate peace with a captive Kuvira, Team Avatar was ambushed. Taken prisoner and hooked up to experimental machines, Bolin and his friends were brainwashed into joining the Earth Empire rebels. Their hypnotized friends then attacked Team Avatar, and Bolin, not recognizing Opal, hit her so hard that she barely walked away from it. In a surprising act of bravery, a redeemed Kuvira undertook a one-woman mission to rescue her unlikely allies. Despite Opal's distrust, Kuvira risked it all and helped three generations of Beifong save the day. Bolin and his friends' hypnosis was soon reversed. Recognizing the change in Kuvira, even a hesitant Opal reconciled with the former dictator. Grateful for all that they had accomplished, Bolin watched as the Beifong family was finally reunited. As far as what's next for this metal clan and the happy couple that helped put them back together, that's all we know for now. From awkward flirting to all the heartbreak and romance along the way, which of Bolin's relationships was your favorite? comment below, and keep watching for more Legend of Korra moments.